This is a Lego train, and this is a city that's waiting for a train. But today, instead of one train, we're going to try to build the perfect team of working Lego trains.
When we started making this video,
we figured we could draw on our years of experience engineering vehicles in real life.
But what we didn't realize was that we'd fall fully in love with Lego trains.
And that this would snowball into the most time-consuming, expensive, but gratifying video we've ever made. But to understand why, we need to start from the beginning.
First, we have to explain why trains are critical.
This is our Lego city, Egopolis. It's designed to be friendly and super livable, and have excellent breakfasts.
But it's just a tiny part of the larger world of Lego cities.
Way out there,
there are other cities, like New Brickerton, Apocalypseburg, your city. All cities with Lego in them are connected via a network that can be accessed with Lego trains.
And without any trains, there's no way for our citizens to get out there or for anyone else to come visit here.
So our citizens are just kind of milling around right now.
So let's help them out.
The first thing we have to do is build the perfect track layout to test our trains on. We want to make sure this is as challenging as possible, so we bought all the Lego train tracks we could find in stock to make sure our track layout has the toughest curves possible.
Lego train track curves are super tight
compared to real-life train tracks because Lego has to fit inside rooms. But we'll make our track even harder by adding some continuous, tight curves, so the trains have to turn all the way around fast, and some curves that switch directions, so the trains have to wiggle back and forth. We're going to have to figure out some weird tricks to get the trains not to derail. And let's add some hills, too, to see if the trains can climb.
So we're going to start here, at Egopolis, and we're going to try to get all the way here, to New Brickerton. Brick Science City is flooded at the moment, so it's off the line.
And we'll design 5 trains that each have a job to see if they can get us through these 5 stages, from start to finish, which will let our citizens connect with the outside world and hopefully fulfill their dreams one day. But only if we can make all the trains work.
And so with that, let's get to work. First, we need a metro train, something that takes our citizens to and from work or the Lego store every day.
Our rule is that everything in our city has to be custom, no Lego sets. So all these trains need to be built from scratch.
We're making our train 6 Lego studs wide so that there's room for 4 studs of train inside, but they're small enough to run fast and be cute. The windows on modern trains blend together into big panels, so we'll use Lego bricks around clear panels to create the same effect.
We want our metro to come on time and run through the middle of the night, unlike BART, our system here, which goes to sleep at midnight. Lego usually works by building upward, but sometimes things look better sideways or upside down, so we use these bracket pieces to flip these curved slopes to shape the edges of the train.
And we'll add some custom printed maps and real-time displays so the riders can see where they're going. To make the train's face, we'll use the same curves, but sideways, and place this window upside down so it helps finish our blue stripe. We build the roof separately so it's easily removable.
So now we need to make it run. Trains run on rails, and Lego rails are 5 studs apart center to center. Since our train needs to go around pretty extreme turns, we can't just attach the wheel axles directly to the car. If we did, the car wouldn't be able to go around curves or through switches, unless it was really, really short. So we build these wheel axles in pairs, so 4 wheels total, into an intermediate assembly called a bogey, and then attach the bogey to the car in a way where it can pivot, using this Lego pin. For this train, we're going to be extra fancy and build a bogey that's attached with pins to both of our train cars. This is called a Jacob's bogey. This reduces rolling friction and lets our train pivot even more than if we had bogeys attached separately to each car. To make sure it moves without us pushing it, we're going to use this Lego motorized piece, which spins whatever you put in it, but the most logical thing to put in it is train wheels, plus a Lego battery box to power the motor.
And then we need some sliding doors, so the minifigs can get in and out. We use these Lego droid arms on a Lego bar to make them swing out, over, and back in. And now the train just needs its name and destination. Now, let's see if it can make these curves.
It works! But even though we have one working train now, our city needs more.
We need something to carry our citizens' food and other supplies from outside town. Right now, they're pretty hungry.
Let's build a freight train
based on the GE Evolution Tier 4, which is the state-of-the-art diesel-electric locomotive running across North America today.
This is when we started appreciating how many details we need to get just right to make a working Lego train.
We need to have 6 pairs of wheels here, like the real locomotive, so we need 2 bogies with 3 axles each. But 3 axle assemblies are hard to make work because the third axle forces all the wheels into a line, so the bogie can't make it around curves, it'll derail. So to fix this, we have to build this special slider for the middle axle, so it can slide left and right and follow the curve of the track. We can't do this for the train motor, so we're just going to pretend these guys are our third set of wheels.
Now we need to sculpt the body with regular Lego techniques. We use these Lego cheese slopes, they look like cheese, to build the pointy, wide nose of the locomotive by building sideways again. Cheese slope pieces have a jagged lip, so to make this seamless, we use Lego bracket pieces to offset each row by half plate increments.
This locomotive has a wide cab, but is narrower behind it so that the operator can turn their head and see the rest of the train. We build a ladder with these handle pieces to get between the high and low walkways.
On the roof, we use these Lego telescopes as the air horns. And in front of that, we'll build the operator's cab with a removable roof. And in the back, we build the radiator cab so the train doesn't overheat. We'll use these Lego grill slopes to build these corrugated radiator grills. We finished the walkway railings with Lego handles and bars, so any walkers don't fall off. And now we can texture the roof with cheese slopes, tiles, and grill tiles.
And now we can design our stickers. Let's waterproof test these too, to make sure they'll survive the rain and slings and arrows of the outside world. By the way, if you want instructions for this or any of the other trains in this video, check out the description below. If you want, we'll even print the stickers for you. But we won't know if this really works until we have some freight cars to pull. So let's build a double stack container car, plus a gondola car for building materials for the city. Okay, the moment of truth. I'm a little skeptical that this will actually work, but let's try it.
Now, what about a train that can get passengers across longer distances, like Amtrak in the US, or the ICE in Germany, or TGV in France?
We're out of bricks, so we need to lay down and call for help. And after getting resupplied, we can build again.
We've modeled this after the Japanese Shinkansen bullet train, with a super pointy nose to go fast. For the power car, we reused a lot of the parts and design from the Lego Express passenger train set, which is a cheaper way to get into custom trains than building from scratch.
The Shinkansen looks a little bit like an airplane or a really fast beluga whale, so we used these Lego plane windows and curved slopes to get the look right. This train goes longer distances than our metro train does, so we have an icy drink service and more legroom. Plus a self-serve coffee machine.
And we'll add doors that swing open with Lego handles and clips. And now we can test if it's ready.
This is where we realized we made a critical mistake.
We'd built three trains, but none of these were the kind of train that everyone knows is a train. We needed a steam train.
The guy who wrote the book on LEGO trains says that steam trains are the hardest trains to build by far. So we're going to try, obviously.
We're trying to build the Pere Marquette 1225, better known as the Polar Express, which has what's called a 2-8-4 wheel configuration, meaning it has two leading wheels, 8 large driving wheels, and 4 trailing wheels.
The trick is getting this huge wheel assembly to run reliably without derailing. First of all, 8 fixed driving wheels won't be able to turn on the curves, so we switched half of them out for wheels that have no flange and so don't touch the track, so they don't get stuck.
And it gets more interesting when we add the leading and trailing wheel assemblies. If they don't pivot exactly the right amount, the car won't get through curves. After a few different prototypes, we found our ideal pivot points.
And then we add these LEGO Technic pieces to connect the driving wheels together.
We have to attach the wheels with a quarter turn offset between the left and right wheels so that the train moves smoothly through the entire piston cycle.
We can't use a LEGO train motor here because we want the wheels and pistons to look and move like a real steam train. We need to use a regular LEGO motor instead, which just spins one axle, and build our own gear train to hook it up to send just enough torque to the driving wheels. And we have to fit this into about 2 studs of width, so it's a little tricky. We've rebuilt this drivetrain 5 different times now, and we're finally happy with it.
And then we just shaped the rest of the body with some fun LEGO pieces. Then we can attach the LEGO motor to finish the locomotive.
Then we build the tender and stick the battery box in there. This is supposed to have 3 axles each in the front and the back. So we'll build 2 of the special triple axle bogies that we designed for the freight train with sliding middle axles.
We're almost there. Let's just build a cute little cable car like in San Francisco, except not $8 to ride. It doesn't even need any bogies. It just chugs straight up and down hills.
And we're out of motors too, so we're just going to push this one with our hands.
To make these stickers, we hand traced the custom painted lettering from the real life cable car because we want it to look just right. And we added some posters too for events that are happening in the city soon.
Time to see what's at the end of the line. Now that we have some trains in the city, we can really get to work.
And if you want to build a LEGO city to get on the train network yourself, watch this next.